Generative Fill is about to change the way you edit in Photoshop, and you can try it out for yourself right now by downloading the latest beta. Let's take a look at how it works. Before we look at the magic of adding and replacing objects, let's get rid of a few first. Many of you may already be familiar with Content-Aware Fill. Select an object, hop into the Fill dialog, choose Content-Aware, and go. In many cases, this works beautifully. But for more complex images like this one, it often mangles the background if there's a lot going on. Once again, I'll use the Object Selection tool to quickly isolate this random runner who decided to join the group. Then, to add a touch of padding, the selection can be expanded by a few pixels. With that set, you'll notice the Generative Fill button on your taskbar. Or if you have it hidden, you can access it under the Edit menu. Here, you can of course type in what you'd like to generate. Or you can leave it blank to remove your selection. And in just a few seconds, poof. Look at how accurate this turned out. As a reminder, here's what Content-Aware Fill returned. And here's Generative Fill. The building, the fencing, and even the shadow at the bottom of the light pole. On top of that, we're given a few variations that we can cycle between over within the Properties panel. Let's try one more. In this example, removing the adorable dog would traditionally be quite the hassle, as you'd have to reconstruct the woman's hair and shirt. But with Generative Fill, it takes care of all that messy work. And in some cases, it even creates a pillow that matches the style of the couch. What? Alright, let's switch gears and replace a few objects. Then I'll show you how your images can be extended using Generative Fill. Let's be real, sometimes fruits are way too healthy. For this example, I'm going to keep my selection nice and messy using one of my lasso tools to select the fruits, the fork, and I'll leave a bit of room at the top. Now, the big question is, what do we replace this with? Ice cream. And just like that, it's not only given us a few options for our new afternoon snack, but it's even correctly replaced the fork with a spoon. What about this orange juice? Let's try replacing it with a coffee. Much better. And maybe, just to wrap this all up, I'll make a selection over to the right and generate a delicious plate of donuts. You know what, fine, let's add some fruits back into this photo, but tucked away in the background. And what's wild about this is that Generative Fill matched the blur for our newly created object. How many times have you asked someone to take a photo, only to realize they took it vertically instead of horizontally? You could crop it, but you might end up losing important parts of your photo. Instead, let's try generating the surrounding area. First, I'll start by selecting the crop tool, and then extend the image out a bit. And just for comparison, let's quickly try Content Aware. It's not terrible, but certainly not something I would post on Instagram. Next, I'll turn the image layer into a selection by holding down Command or Control and clicking on the layer's thumbnail. Then we'll want to bring the selection in a touch using the Contract option. Finally, let's invert the selection so we're focused primarily on the missing area. Alright, the moment of truth. If you have something specific in mind, you can enter it here. Otherwise, leave it blank and generate away. And with that, everything changes. I'm going to be uploading more videos covering Generative Fill on YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram, so definitely go ahead and follow me there, and I'll see you all in the next one.